Aloha, we are live from Hawaii. This is Martina Wing talking about manta rays again. I'm a passionate manta ray lover and an advocate for them. And I go live every Wednesday at 11 o'clock and I just want to teach you more about, teach you about the animal itself and things to do here in Kona, because we are the hub in the world, one of the hubs in the world to see manta rays in their natural environment. And I believe many people would enjoy learning about them before they come. Or for all the folks that came here, that this is a place to be to see manta rays. Anyway, so this is a manta ray. Just make sure that you know what we're talking about. It's not a stingray or an eagle ray or bat ray or cow ray. Many rays in the ocean. But I wanted to give you the basic anatomy today, because it's just a little weird looking creature. And we have done all the names for it prepared. And it's a little easier for us if we do this on the screen. And so I'm going to flip my screen real quick so you have something to look at and see and learn the names of each part of their body visually. So give me a second. I'm going to just switch over to my screen. And here we go. And these are the manta rays that we're going to look at. And so let's go into the basic anatomy of a manta ray. So we have fins, we call them pectoral fins. This is right here. We have the eye right here, and we have a cephalic horn, which I'm going to go into detail a little bit more later on. But this is the first part, and then of course they have a tail. I mentioned earlier that there's stingrays out there, and most people know about it because of Steve Irwin's. Glenn is here. How are you doing, Glenn? This is great. So this the tail is here, and but I talked about stingrays. So stingrays actually have a stinger and teeth. Excuse me, they have a stinger and they can actually hurt you. And Steve Irwin had a really big bad problem at the very end of his life. In 2006 it all happened. But manta rays do not have a stinger or teeth or barb. So this is just the tail, and people ask me all the time, do they need this? We do have manta rays, two manta rays over the years that we had, Captain Kirk and Maki Ray. They didn't have a tail and they were around for a long time and had no problem without a tail. Pectoral fin, eye, cephalic horn, and the tail. This is the first slide. Then the second one is the mouth is in the front. So this is the mouth, and it's actually closed right now. And this would be a dorsal fin. And it's kind of cool when you see the manta ray swimming on the surface and the dorsal fin sticks out, and many people are like, oh my God, there's a shark. Well, it's not a shark, it's a manta ray. But actually, they're correct, because manta rays belong to the shark family. But it's just the dorsal fin here at the back of their body. And it's definitely to maneuver and make them, they're so acrobatic when they move and use this for maneuvering. Okay, so the next slide is the underside of the manta ray. So the manta rays here on that we see regularly on the manta experience are reef mantas. Hey, Tara is back. Hello, Tara. This is great. Aloha to you too. So underside of the manta ray, white, predominantly white with spot pattern. And so the arrow is pointing towards between the place between their gill slits right here. And this is called the unique spot pattern. Think of a fingerprint. And we do identify the manta rays. And there are over 260 in the database at this point. And there are really cool names over the years, like Ray Charles Ray and Sugar Ray and Tango Ray. And there's a Martina Ray too. And the newest one is Pu'uwai. And if you want to check out one of the last Facebook Lives we had, it was a contest. And we had 50 submissions from people all over the world to name the newest manta ray. But check it out, it's just a different Facebook Live. Down here are also pelvic fins, right here. Right there, this would be a female too. But they have pelvic fins. And let's go to the next one. Gill slits, that's a very clear picture of their gill slits. So they have five on each side, right here. And so when the water goes into their mouth and their filter feed the plankton and the water, through their system, the water comes back out underneath on the underside through their gill slits, and the plankton actually stays in their mouth and will be filtered through the gill rakers. A little bit more about the cephalic fin. I have a video later on. And earlier I said it's called a cephalic horn, and now I'm calling it cephalic fin, and I'm going to tell you about this here in a second. So, and the next slide is actually the mouth of a manta ray. If you look from the front, it looks like a big cavernous mouth, and yes, it is big for sure. And what you see here is the black part is called the gill raker, and the white part is called the gill arch. What the gill arch does, it just keeps the cavity open. And so yes, manta rays can close their mouth and can open it up. And when the water and the plankton goes into their mouth, the gill raker, the water goes through the gill rakers and gill slits comes out on the underside, like I mentioned earlier on this gill raker, gill slits. And then the gill rakers actually rake the plankton to the back, and now we have the esophagus sitting here in the back. So a manta ray's mouth is definitely intimidating just because of by size, and people just think, oh my God, they're going to swallow me. Well, they can't swallow you. They don't have the ability to swallow other anything else than plankton, and they don't even eat fish. And I had it two or three times that I saw a fish coming, getting caught, and it's just, they spit it out. And I will show you a video on another time about that. Cool. So this is about this part, and then I mentioned earlier that manta rays have no stinger and no teeth and no barb. Well, they do have a tooth band. I do want to mention that just on the bottom, but it's not developed. It's just a little tiny, and there's nothing to be fearful about. Manta rays are gentle giants, and you don't have to think. They're just protection. Their protection in the ocean is their sheer size. They just swim away if they need to, and yeah, so there is a tooth band, but it's really not teeth that would bite you. There's also no suction to the mouth. I want to make sure you know that. It's just they swim through the food that is in abundance in front of them. And that would then, if you want to see how the manta ray experience works, where we turn on lights at night, another Facebook Live that we checked that we did the other day, just check out our gallery for more information. So, and then I promised you some videos. I'm going to have to just get to those. Let's see. I want to get you a little bit more into this cephalic fin. And of course, just enjoy the imagery that we have captured over all these years. Now check this out. This is the manta ray Vicky Ray. She has the cephalic horns. And there's Timbuktu, and he has cephalic fins. So what's the big difference? Well, the cephalic horn is rolled up in front of them if they just cruising along. And this was actually a night where we didn't have much plankton. So some manta rays started to feed, or thought they were feeding, they were ready for it with the fins down, and Vicky was just not ready to eat, Vicky Ray, and she just kept her cephalic horns in front of her. And it's just really cool footage, and you see how slow they're actually moving. Yeah, this would make the manta ray really hydrodynamic if they're just cruising, and if the cephalic fin is down, like here, this is, would be dragging, and so it wouldn't make them so fast. And on a side note, this is actually a really cool display of mating behavior, where you where the Timbuktu is following Vicky Ray. And but this is another topic I can talk about. This whole, chasing each other reproduction, I guess we would call that. Alrighty. So this is this clip I wanted to show you, and then I do have a little bit of a close up of Vicky again with the cephalic horn. Just let me go to that very quick. And now you can see actually how she rolls them up and rolls them down. Just watch closely. See how it comes down here? I'm going to go back to this again. Check it out, how it comes down. And then she can also roll them back up. So super flexible, the cephalic fin. And they use them to feed, or they use them as horns if they need to be hydrodynamic in the water to keep moving forward. All right. And this are the basic anatomy of the manta rays. And this was a night, you see all the customers down here, all the divers, they're just in total awe to have such a beautiful big fish on top of them. All right, let's go back to look at my face. There you go. And thanks for staying with me. I just want to give you the basic anatomy. It's a shorter video today, but I think this is all makes sense. It's all about the manta rays. If you like the stuff we're doing here on Facebook Live every Wednesday, so give us a like, give us a share. Come on and join us on Wednesdays at 11 o'clock. We also put these videos on YouTube, so whatever you is the most comfortable place for you, give us a like, give us a share. Just stay connected and Manta rays need as much protection as possible, and if you know more about this creature, I know you will fall in love with them as well, like I did so many years ago. So that's for it. Thanks for joining today, and thanks for Tara and Glenn to be here, and I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.